Welcome to hardhatengineer.com. I am Varun Patel. Visit my website hardhatengineer.com to learn more about piping.
In this lecture, we are going to learn about what is alloy steel is. When we add various metallic or non-metallic element in specific amount to the carbon steel, it will change the property of the carbon steel. We can manipulate this percentage of alloying element in the steel to achieve better property than carbon steel. What is alloy steel? As learned earlier, adding of alloying element to improve the characteristic of material is termed as alloy steel. Alloy steel can further be classified as low alloy steel and high alloy steel. When the sum of the total alloying element is less than 5% by weight, it is known as low alloy steel, whereas if it is greater than 5%, it is high alloy steel. Commonly used alloying elements are chrome, nickel, molybdenum, manganese, vanadium, titanium, silicon, boron, aluminum, cobalt and tungsten. What is the purpose of adding alloying elements? Depends on their quantities in the material. These elements affect the material property such as corrosion resistance, hardenability, machinability. It will also impact the temperature stability of the material, ductility, toughness. Alloying elements improve the wear resistance and weldability of the material. Alloy steel can be used in a process area where carbon steel has a limitation, such as high temperature services, low temperature services and high pressure services. Common alloy steel grade that used in piping are, for the pipe it is ASTM A335 grade P1, P5, P11, for rock product ASTM 234, WP1, WP5, for forge fitting it is ASTM A182, F21, F5, F9, F11, etc. Let's summarize what you have learned in this lecture. You learn about what is alloy steel is. You also learn about different alloying elements which commonly used to improve the property of the carbon steel, purpose of the adding alloying elements and use of the alloy steel. We also seen some of the common grade that used in piping. See you in the next lecture.